So, hello and welcome to a new video on my channel. I'm your Yugi Joker, and today I have yet another two display opening. Today I have a guest with me. I have a girlfriend with me. She will open one display and I will open one display. We already got rid of the plastic around the boxes. So I will give one to her and one box for me. And we'll see who will get the better display at the end of the day. Okay, so let's start with the first booster pack. And let's see what we get. As you can see, we have the German packs yet again. And we still hope to get one of the Starlight Rares. And as always, I will put the Super Rares, Ultra Rares and Secrets on the side. And all the comments on the other one. So let's see what we can get. So there's another Parallax C, that's pretty good. And a lot of comments, so Red Resonator support. So, okay, Plunder Patrols, Evil Eye, Old Warrior, Codebreaker, and the Burning Draw, which is just the draw spell for the Settlement Grid archetype. And to be honest, this card is not the best. Maybe it will see play in the future, maybe. So we have more shark support, more resonator support, and our first ultra rare, which is Deep Sea Prima Donna. Well, the Mermaid and Deep Sea archetype got a lot of support, and this is one of the better ones, to be honest. So maybe we see the same pattern as in the last two display openings. Now we had all the secrets on one side and all the ultras, or three or four ultras on one side. So it's first ultra rare for the right side, and last time it was three ultra rares for the right side and one ultra rare for the left side. So this is Malice, which is a pretty interesting card. It's the Lair of Darkness support, and it would actually be the sneak peek promo, but at the moment there are no sneak peeks, so maybe in the future we will see this card at a higher price because there are no sneak peeks, maybe. So this is just Nemesis support, which is actually a pretty decent archetype. We have more AIs, Gookies, and oh, this is the land something. The shark support is shark Xyz, so even sharks get a lot of support. So we're still up to three ultra rares and two secrets. Okay, let's see, we should get close to the next ultra rare, as I said. Yeah, this is a Planet Patrol emblem, one of the most needed cards, I would say, for the Planet Patrol in a new format, since they're kind of revolving around equipping each other and not discarding like the first support. But it's definitely not bad. More Planet Patrol support, well, always nice to see. Like I said last time, it's not a deck for me, and it looks like we have the same pattern as last time. It definitely looks like it, so we should get one more ultra rare on this side. Oh, this is the Corridor. From our last two displays I got none of these, so this is my first, and I actually need two, so maybe we see another one. And if the pattern continues, this should be an ultra rare again, because this is the last package from the right side. Let's see, is it an ultra rare? Kind of, yeah. This is Loptra, the generator card. Definitely good. It gives the archetype a lot of new ways to play and not focusing around the field spell that much. So you can play with the Condemned Witch a lot. So like last time, right side, three ultra rares. Left side should be two secrets and one ultra. This is kind of weird if it actually is like that. So we have the next corridor. And I have my second one. That's perfect. So weird, this time two of this, last time none. And there's the first secret, which is the Archosaura. Definitely good support for the Dino archetype. And a buddy of mine actually plays dinos, and I already sold the last one. So maybe I get to sell this one as well. This Gachiri, one of the Ignista cards. To be honest, I don't think the Ignista cards are that good. I mean, I still have my play, deck around, but it's not a good deck, to be honest. It's not good. So, more Parallax Seed, one of the best commons in the set. I think this was either World Premiere card or OCG import. Not quite sure, but it's definitely new for the TCG. Alright. So, okay, Deep Sea Aria. The second secret. So, it's as well Deep Sea support. Or like normal support if you want. And then there should be one last ultra rare. This is Aria, okay. Aria is a potential Starlight rare, but I don't think I'm that lucky. So let's see. Medolge Promenade, okay. So last time I only got one in two displays. Maybe this time I get more of this. Always resetting playsets is obviously better than singles. And there it is, the Crocodragon. Got one last time, so this is the last ultra rare. That's cool. So I got two of this in three displays. Maybe there's a playset in the last one. And if there's no factory error, then this should be already all the ultra rares and all the secret rares. But there's potential still hidden Starlight rare. So this is Witchcrafter support. I think I got one last time, so this is my second one. And this is the last booster from the first display, and this should be, yeah, should be a super rare. Alright, so more Witchcrafter support. And that's it for the first display, so now we're gonna change things up, and my girlfriend is going to open the other display, and I'm just gonna cut here. So as you can see, we can start with the second display, and my girlfriend is going to open them. She actually was way more luckier than me last time, so maybe this time she has more luck as well. And let's see what we can have for the first time. It's Nemesis Corridor for the super rare, which is definitely not bad. So I actually got my playset now. Okay, she's going to present them to you. Oh, please, please don't. Please don't. Guys, don't be too mean to her. Okay, let's see. So, okay, this is not the same pattern as last time. This is the right side, and we got our first secret rare on this. So, three displays had the same pattern, and this one is the first one. It has another pattern for the secrets and ultra rares. That's kind of interesting. Okay, let's look further through the displays. Okay, it's the new Invoked Fusion. It's okay. So in the last two displays, I got two of these, and this is the first one in two displays. So it's kind of short printed for super rare, kind of. It's not the most common, and it's a really, really good super rare you should have for your Invoked or Shadow decks. So this is a Rose Girl. Rose Girl for the Rose Plant Synchro support. It's actually a pretty good extender for the archetype. Okay, there's another crocodragon. This is the third one I had in four displays. So actually got a play set and four displays. Not too bad for an ultra rare. So this is definitely not short printed. Okay, keep things going. It's AI contact, more Agnista support. Like I said, not a good archetype, not a good. So the card in itself is really good, but the archetype, it's pure shit. And the next super rare is the Gachiri at Ignissa. Yeah, Ignissa support. What do you want to do? So just for a little disclaimer on the side, in the next few days there are gonna be some deck profiles of mine. For example, a cubic deck profile, an infinity deck profile, and stuff like that. Some more of the rogue and underrated decks, but they're not gonna be on my channel. But as soon as they are up on the other channel, which I'm not gonna tell you right now, guys, is I'm gonna inform you. So I'm gonna do a video on my channel, telling you the videos on the other channel, more likely. Something around this. So we're almost finished with the first side, and we only got one secret and one ultra rare. And this is the second one. It's Plunder Patrol Emblem. So it's the fourth, actually. My fourth emblem. So two ultra rares, one secret for the first half. Maybe another pattern in the display indicates that we have the chance of getting a starlight rare, which would be more than awesome. So Gusari at Ignissa is the next super rare, and this is the last booster of the right side. We're gonna end the first half with another Invoke Fusion. Okay. Definitely a card you can use. Definitely a card you want. Now we're going to start with the left side of the display. And let's see what you can pull out of this. So it's one of the Senkas, one of the old warrior, ancient warrior cards. This is like Ignissa archetype, which didn't do anything. And I'm kind of disappointed. So another Witchcrafter support card. And a lot of comments no one really cares about. Okay, this is another Witchcrafter support. Okay, Witchcrafter actually saw some replays of this deck, and it kind of looks like the new wave of the old spell cards. So definitely familiar, but I'm not quite sure if they are going to do anything about the meta. So this is one of the new Machina cards, and in conjunction with the new structure deck, they can actually do kind of a lot, but definitely not meta changing. So the next one is one of the Plunder Patrols. In the patrol party. Yeah, the trap card is actually kind of nice. It's I think it should be at least a two off in the deck, but I think three are definitely too much. Maybe there are some Planet Patrol players out there who can tell me more about it. But like I said in last video, I'm not gonna play this deck, and I'm not really hyped for this deck. So I'm more than happy to give all the Planet Patrol cards away. So when I have the correct overview, we still have yet one ultra rare to go and one secret rare. This is definitely something you don't want to see if you have the last three packets. So I'm still hoping for a Starlight rare, but yeah, this is kind of rare. So this is the arrival at Ignissa, so the very first Link 6 card, and it's definitely a good card, but only in the Ignis archetype, which is kind of sad. And next we have the Dragon Mage, yeah, Xiao, Xiaoying, something like that. So it's my second copy of this card, and if you play the Extravagance build, you actually need three. But I got myself covered, so this is one I have left over. So I still have one secret rare to go. One more secret. This is an Ancient Warrior card, okay. And I think we're down to the last two boosters. So two boosters, and there should be at least one secret rare. But you always can hope for a Factory Error or Starlight Rare. So this is the Super Rare Plunder Patrol. And now we're going to go to the very last booster, and it should be a secret rare. If not, we have a Factory Error box of the bad side. Let's see what's in the package. And yes, it's one of the Croco again. So I got a playset of this card, and I'm more than happy to sell this to a buddy of mine. Yeah, so as you can see, we got two secrets, four ultra rares out of two this place again. So no Factory Error this time, not like the I think Rising Rampage was the last one I had. So thank you guys for tuning in, and see you guys next time.